What's up, everybody? This is Nikko Taylor, and welcome to another episode of Trench TV. On today's episode, I have a former Tennessee Vol and current Seahawks offensive lineman. Here is Kahlil Mckenzie. Now, wait, hold on. Before we go anywhere, before you do anything, make sure you share it, subscribe it, whatever platform you're watching on. Make sure you tell your friend, your pets, your uncle, aunties, coaches, and all of that, and tell them to tune in to Trench TV. Kahlil, let's get it. Like, how close are you and your dad, really?
Oh, man, we like this, you know. I was blessed to have mom and dad in the home at all times. Mm-hmm. My pop's been working my whole life, you know, showed me the way from a young age. So, you know, me and my pop's like this.
Okay. Now, I could kind of tell just like y'all was working out, y'all was vibing. How much of an influence do you think he's had on you in the whole football game?
Man, I mean, just the simple fact, I mean, I ain't never heard nobody say nothing bad about him. You know, I've been around football my whole life, and I've never heard nobody say nothing about my pops in a negative way. So, I mean, that speaks volumes.
Man.
That's something that I know I can – that's not going to happen for me, you know? like knowing that it's like that for him, that's big.
A lot of times when a coach tell you that you got to change positions, people usually get sour about it. So, like, how was your transition having to change from D-line to O-line?
I mean, I wasn't sour about it. You know, it was a new opportunity. Shoot, I got drafted. You know what I mean? So, like, I wasn't tripping about it like that. To me, I was more than anything, I was just surprised, I guess is the right word. Mm-hmm. But I was like, shoot, let's go. You know, I was excited about it. You know, I kind of just took it as a new challenge. And I thought the first year went well for me. Second year, kind of things I thought were going well. But ended up getting cut by the Chiefs at their training camp. So, but ended up got a fresh start in Seattle, which I'm really liking it out there. Then did the XFL just to try and get some more reps in this offseason. Ended up hurting myself first game.
In the XFL?
Yeah, and didn't even get to play. So I was just out there. Yeah. But I got to practice and get some reps at center and just get some more reps at guard and just live reps, things like that. Because, you know, when you're on, you know, because I was on P squad last year in Seattle, you're doing stuff, but you're not really doing
that. It ain't the same.
Yeah, it ain't the same. So I just want to get them reps and, you know, I'm trying to, you know, fight for a position. And they didn't even see me play a game at O-line yet. And that was kind of the point of me doing the XFL, but I didn't even get to do that. So it is what it is. But still, just trying to work at it. I like O-line. You know, it's different. It's a whole lot different.
I tell people
all the time, I'm like, imagine you only walk forward your whole life. And then somebody told you to walk backwards. That's exactly how it is. And then do smart things.
On top of D-line just reckless. We just going to go get it. O-line, a whole different vibe. So your brother play O-line. Who right now will be the better O-lineman? Or who has him by far?
Yeah.
He cold like that?
Yeah. I mean, he cold like that. And, I mean, he's been playing O-line way too long. I've been playing O-line since this, sophomore year? Don't stand a chance.
So, could O-line Jalen block D-line Kahlil?
No. that's completely different. O-line Jalen, that's about it. O-line Jalen could block better than O-line Kahlil right now. I would give him that.
On today's BumpBoxx break, we got nothing but a G thing by Snoop Dogg.
1, 2, 3 into the folks. Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Dre is at the door, ready to make an entrance, so back on up,
'cause you know we're about to rip this up.
Give me the microphone first so I can bust like a bubble. Compton and Long Beach together, now you know you in trouble. Ain't nothing but a G-thang, baby. Too low depth, so get over crazy. Death Row is the label that pays, man. Unfadable, so please don't try to...
What do you think the best thing, like, football has taught you?
Respect. You know, I say respect because you got to respect the game. You know what I'm saying? You got to respect your fans. You know what I'm saying? And you got to respect your coaches and your teammate. You know, so, and you got to respect yourself. So it's a lot to go into it. It's a lot of different aspects of respect. Like, what does respect for your team look like? You know what I'm saying? That, you know, that's, you know, protecting the team name, not going out there acting crazy, all this type of stuff. What does protecting your teammate look like? Oh, shoot. You know, that's making sure that, you know, they're getting home safe if they go do something crazier. You know, you checking up on people, you know, somebody passed away. You know what I'm saying? So all that respect, you know, respect your coaches, being able to listen, you know, when people are telling you something about yourself, and then being able to correct somebody, you know, or being able to stand your ground against somebody who's going to test you too now. You know what I'm saying? That's all the part of respect.
Both sides.
That's how you gain respect. Yeah, that's how you gain respect from a lot of these cats. So, you know what I'm saying?
How you feel about what's been going on the past 400 years or a couple of days, however you want to word it? How you feel about it?
You can't expect people to not want change, for one. Not because it's the just human thing to do. You said you were going to change. You know what I mean? From the first time when it was, oh, slavery is abolished. You know, they said, okay. But then we had indentured servitude. Then it's, oh, we're Reconstruction. But then you have Jim Crow. So it's like, not just, you know, we understand that we're humans. We understand that, you know, we have rights. We have rights. We have human rights, not U.S. rights, this, that. No, we have human rights, and that they're not being recognized.
Thank you, Kahlil, for coming on. Appreciate you, bro, for sharing your story. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. Kahlil, go ahead and send us out.
Oh, man, appreciate you, man. Thank you for having me. Kahlil Mckenzie, one more time, offensive guard for the Seattle Seahawks. Appreciate you, Nikko Trenches, having me on here, man.
It's new rules, new dudes, new goons, new tools, new crews, new news, new cars, new jewels. See that boy with that ice, shining up under them lights. See that boy with that chopstick, bet you he's selling that rice. Bet you he having this money and getting this.